safety by guarding ourselves. Amen? Let us stand. May the word of God that has prepared for us this morning will really bless each one of us. The text for this morning is found in Acts chapter 2, from verse 42 to verse 47. Now the context of this verse is after Jesus has already given his last testaments, last words to the disciples, he ascended to heaven. Before he ascended to heaven, he has made all the great commission and all the things that we have to do. Then he said to the disciples, don't leave until the coming of the Holy Spirit will be upon you. So what the disciples did, they stayed in the upper house, and in the upper house, in their group, they prayed, they tarried until the Holy Spirit came upon them. And after the Holy Spirit came upon them, they speaking in tongues, they spoke in tongues, and the people in the city were in chaos, asking what is happening with these disciples of Jesus. So they mob around the building, and here is Peter, the speaker of the group, and he shared the gospel and the prophecies that were fulfilled by the coming of the Holy Spirit. And after that, he has preached the gospel to the people. And the Bible said that there were 3,000 new believers came to Jesus. And after that incident, the days come after the day of Pentecost, these were the things that they were doing after the day of Pentecost. So I bring it to you. And they continued steadfastly in the apostles' preaching and fellowship, and in the breaking of bread, and the prayers, and fear came upon every soul, and many wonders and signs were done through the apostles. And all the believers were together and had all things common, and they sold their possessions and goods and parted them all according as any man had need. And day by day, araw-araw, continuing steadfastly with one accord in the temple and breaking bread at home, they took their food with gladness and singleness of heart, praising God and having favor with all the people. And the Lord added to them day by day those that were saved. Let us bow our heads. Heavenly Father, we just want to thank you this morning for a very great opportunity to listen to the Holy Spirit as your servant will share your word. Let every eye, let every mind and heart be prepared in the name of Jesus to receive your word, so that his word will be life and the proof of our singing, that there will be refreshing. Let everyone be refreshed by your word in Jesus' mighty name. And I cast out all the obstacles, including the bad spirits that are planning to enter the blessings of God. And I plead the blood of Jesus to cover us as we listen to your precious word. I bless everyone, Lord, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen, Lord. Amen. Have your seats and enjoy the word of God. And I come across with a research conducted by Berna. You know, Berna is a group of researchers, but their focus is on conducting researches about religious groups. And most of these researchers are paid, binabayaran sila ng mga different religious groups and other groups that are looking into the different variables or the different factors affecting the religious groups. This is based in California, and what the Barna Group will issue, you know, a Barna Group is something like a bus station survey or kaya ay guest overlay survey in the Philippines. But the Barna Group, when they release an issue, the religious groups or the sects or other religions are being affected by the results of the research. And in this research, there are about 1,000 pastors or ministers of the gospel. And there are about 5,000 adults. Adults here in America includes a minimum age of 18 years above. So there are about 5,000 respondents. The first question that was asked to the 6,000 people is about what is the process of growing spiritually? Because after we receive our salvation, our sonship of the Father, while we are living on earth as strangers, because we are not of the earth, we are to the heavens, we are citizens of heaven, but we are still on earth, it is expected of us to grow in our relationship with the Lord Jesus. And when this question was asked, the answers were 1. Growing spiritually to 43% of the 6,000 is becoming more like Christ. Meaning, when you are still living on earth, you live like Christ, then you are growing spiritually. 31% pertains to spiritual growth, and 18% of the 6,000 said that growing spiritually means discipleship, or you must be disciple. And when they were asked about how is discipleship in your church, the answers are the following. 60% of the 6,000 said that they are not doing well in discipleship. They are not doing well. 40% of the participants said probably, meaning they are not sure. Meaning they have no facts or concrete data proving that there is an effective discipleship in their church. Only 8% said that discipleship in their church is growing well. And about 1% of the 6,000 participants said that the young believers are not disciple in their church. When I say young believers, these are individuals whose age is below 18. Then another question, since said that 73% said that they put emphasis on the spiritual growth. And I think the spiritual growth must be the focus of every church. And 77% believe the importance of the spiritual growth. Let us have this question for all of you in your inner Better Assembly of God Church. Let us do the survey. To those of you who believe that spiritual growth is important, please raise your hand. Is spiritual growth important? Raise your hand. Okay. So about 90%+ said that it is important. And a bit 10% said that they are not sure. No, kasi hindi po nagtaas. 20% of adults are involved in discipleship. The target of the Ilocos Assembly of God is for all of us, 100%. 100% of the believers in the Ilocos Assembly of God temple must be involved in discipleship. 17% met their spiritual mentor. 41% they said that there is a lack of things to do to grow spiritually, because growing spiritually is not an easy task. Growing spiritually will not happen if we will just sit down and relax. Growing spiritually is not only happening when you go to the church once a week. It is impossible, because based on research, a less of majority of the wisdom that said that there are lots of things to do so that we will grow spiritually. Intimate person said there are some things to do to grow spiritually. And when they were asked what are the methods to do for discipleship, and these are the various answers. One, and the second person to them said that they disciple their own self. Who among you disciple yourself? They themselves is the discipler, and they themselves are the disciples. They do it privately, 41%. Another method is by a small group. 25% said there must be a small group. And others, one-on-one, 21%. And 29% said they are being discipled by someone. Now, the disciple, discipling somebody is called discipler, the one who disciple. And there are about 19% of the 6,000 are disciples. And then we were asked, what is the best method of discipling? They said that the most effective, more than the majority of them said, that the small group is the best way to disciple. Meaning, a believer must be in a small group. How small? It depends upon the numbers or the quantity that we will be described. Because a small is very relative. Because during the synagogue, the largest number of members of the synagogue, in the name of Jesus, is about 12. So that's the smallest or the biggest number in the synagogue. So it will be maybe the middle small group is 12. But Jesus has its 12. So the G12 comes from that principle. You cannot have the G12. And another effective is about 29%. They say that it must be one-on-one. There are religious organizations in the Philippines that they can have one-on-one. One best example is the Victory Church. And now I have a friend, a pastor in Victory Church. They are doing one-on-one evangelism or one-on-one discipleship. Now, whether it is by a small group, whether you will be discipled by someone, whether you will be a discipler, whether it will be one-on-one, the law in the Bible is this, that each one of us must be in a group. I repeat, the Bible speaks that each of us must be in a group. Pakisabi nyo nga, I must be in a group. Repeat, yung buhay, life, I must be in a group. Ayon, may buhay. Dapat nakukumbis namin sa sarili natin that we must be in a group because when we speak, it declares two things. It's either we declare blessing or we declare curse. So let us be very careful. So when we speak something, we have to declare blessings.